scary. It's Halloween. You know how you know it's Halloween? Because there's these live pumpkin decorations behind me, and I'm wearing a sweater. Whoa, it's really cold here in October in Colorado. What are you doing?
Just getting a drink.
Why are you wearing shorts? It's Halloween.
It's August.
It's not August, it's Halloween. I'm Steve Spangler, and I'm all about making science fun. For the last 20 years, I've been teaching ways to turn ordinary science experiments into unforgettable learning experiences. I have an amazing team who will do whatever it takes to affect the way people think about science. And to do that, I live by one motto: make it big, do it right, give it class. So I know a lot of you are squeamish. Well, some people are squeamish, right? Don't like the blood, and you're worried about needles. You're a little scared about that. Thank goodness, NASA to the rescue, because they've come up with a special potion right here. All you have to do is you have to dip your hand in it, and it makes you pass out, so you have to be careful. But look at this. This actually opens up the little capillaries in your hand, and while you can't see it here like this, the blood is right at the surface. And the way that you can tell is here. Watch this. See? It goes right to the... Oh. Okay, I didn't really pass out. Got a little woozy, but I didn't actually pass. This is a cool thing to do during Halloween, especially when you want to freak a friend out. And some simple little tricks that you can try with these messages, so to speak, that appear. And the bloody hand is a great example of that. Believe it or not, two secrets. First one, the paper. It's goldenrod paper. Now, goldenrod paper, this is actually what it's called, is goldenrod paper. The special thing about goldenrod paper is some of the paper actually is made with a coloring that really is an indicator. So that means I'm gonna have to take you back to high school chemistry class. Do you remember you had that litmus paper and you dip it in, and one side of the scale it was an acid and the other side of the scale it was a base? It's that whole pH thing. Seven's neutral. Anything that's 1 through 6.9, right, considered acidic, right? And anything that's 7.1 to 14 is considered to be basic. And so it's that teeter-totter. Well, believe it or not, that simple sheet of goldenrod paper is truly an acid-base indicator, which means that it changes color in either a presence of an acid or a base. In this particular case, it's a base. Now, ammonia is not necessarily a very strong base, but it's perfect for this, and it's easy to find at the grocery store. And all I did was this. I took a container in this particular case, and I used a beaker to make it seem medical-ish, right? And I added just a little bit, so maybe 60 milliliters, real world, 2 ounces for Americans, right, of ammonia in here, and then I added some water. And you can kind of test it if you want to, but one of those things with a base is that when you put your hand inside and you feel it, it feels a little slippery. Soaps are basic, and so not all soaps will do this, but needless to say, ammonia works very well. So I just dip my hand down into the ammonia, and then when I slap it on the paper, you can see what happens. So here's how it works. The piece of goldenrod paper goes on the table, or some teachers, like a teacher in a classroom, might put this up on a chalkboard and slap their hand this way. But bottom line is, all we have to do is to touch some of this liquid to it, and you'll see that there's a color change. See this? That's your color change. It's actually indicating that there's a presence of a base that's there. Notice the one that I did at the very beginning, the handprint isn't nearly as visible as it was before, because in the presence of an acid, it will turn back. We didn't take anything like, we didn't take vinegar and pour it on there. We used a really weak acid called carbon dioxide. By simply breathing on it, like this, the carbon dioxide from your breath, although not a lot, is enough to be able to form carbonic acid, and that's the change that you see going back. So this will turn back into a regular yellow sheet of paper, ready for us to slap again. See the same sheet of paper, I can do it again, just having a little of that ammonia water on my hands. Now, if we had vinegar, this will go back very quickly. So here, watch this. You can kind of see it change back very, very quickly. So this is what it looks like if you were to flood it with the acid. But we don't have to do that. Just carbon dioxide is more than enough to be able to turn it back. But goldenrod paper is the secret. All right, one word of warning. Not all goldenrod paper works, meaning you put ammonia on goldenrod paper and it may not work. So you don't want to go buy a whole ream of this stuff if it doesn't work. And if you head to your local office supply center, you don't want to be walking in with a bottle of ammonia. You just look weird. So you're going to want a small little container, some cotton swabs. You can just kind of sit in the aisle and do this. Or get a spray bottle. This is even better. Put a little bit of ammonia water in there, and then you can just kind of quietly in the aisle just do this. And if it changes color, you know you got the right Raymond. You want to buy it from Office Depot. Quality products, less price. I mean, Office Max. Staples. Who's our sponsor? We don't have a sponsor? I don't care where you buy it. Just go get some paper. As fun as this is, it's not all about just making the paper turn red with the base, the ammonia. You can actually do some pretty cool things, almost like a secret message. So let me show you how to write your own secret message. So here's what we want to do. Wherever the ammonia touches the goldenrod paper, that's where you have the change. So if you could make it so the ammonia is not touching the paper, then you would see the message appear. Make sense? So get some candle wax. So you just for the sake of this, watch this. I can just scribble like this. See? And then, all right, so you kind of push this off here. So under the right light, see, I even picked up a little ammonia that was on the table. But under the right light, you don't even see the scribbles. All right, Higginsworth, can you see the scribbles? You can, you're lying. But under the right light, you shouldn't be able to see it, all right? So now you squirt like this, watch this. Look at the scribbles. They start to appear. So the trick here is you got to come up with the best secret message possible. I think I know it. Red rum. Watch this. You can even fool your friends by doing magic. Higginsworth, pick a number between 1 and let's say 4.5 billion.
332,411.
No, 13. Check this out. Watch. See? Magic. Higginsworth is not a very good magician. Well, if you're tired of that ammonia smell, don't worry. I have another secret message, and here's some stuff you're going to need. Look at this. Scissors from Office Depot. This pen from Office Max. A little bit of the Staples action here. This is from Target. This is from Kmart. These cups are from Walmart. And this black light is from SteveSpanglerScience.com. They're a sponsor, right? Solid. Before I show you the secret, I gotta show you what you're doing. Watch this. I just took a regular red cup and cut this little piece of paper out and glued it and used this as a way to be able to put the little spider. So see the spider? Empty cup, but magic light right here, and there's spirits inside the cup. Spirits not included. Higginsworth, turn off the lights. Watch this. See the spider? Watch. Oh, scary. Higginsworth, turn on the lights. I'm scared. It's done. How did I do that? The secret, these highlighters. See, the highlighters have this fluorescent ink that's inside. So if you take the highlighter and put it here like this, you know what a highlighter looks like, and this blue one here. But as soon as it's under black light, it fluoresces very, very nicely. So we're gonna use this to be able to shine through the paper. So you can see how you can't see it on this side, but watch when you shine, so you can kind of see that little light showing up there. Well, we're gonna make the message even better just on a regular sheet of paper. You gotta cut out the circle first. Start with your red cup from Costco, and you simply take the pen from Walmart and you trace around the piece of paper that I got at Office Depot. I'm just gonna trace around here like this. Bingo. Now I'm gonna use my scissors from Staples and cut out the circle. Done. Now we're going to write the secret message backwards using the yellow highlighter on the piece of paper. Here, give me a second. Done. All right, this is my secret message. And you want to take a little bit of glue, and you're going to put just a tiny little glue for all you little Marty Stewarts out there, right around the edge. Now you take the red cup and put the red cup down over the glue there on the rim. Bingo. And you hold it right in place like that. So the secret message is actually underneath here, and you can't see it until you shine the light source up from underneath. That means we need to put a hole in the cup. For that, the scissors that I got from Kmart. Poke the hole and you've got it. All right, this is a perfect place now to be able to put the little keychain black light. Perfect. Ready for the secret message? Higginsworth, turn off the lights. Thank you. Watch this.
a secret message. Rad Rom. Happy Halloween. Black and white, boring, spooky.
What's cool about the blue highlighter is that you can leave one message on the very front, so this design on the front, and then when you put the black light back here, the blue highlighter almost seems to disappear. Hey, Higginsworth, turn off the lights, watch this. It almost seems to disappear as that whatever's below kind of shines through. Be creative, you'll come up with your own thing. And my personal favorite, Higginsworth did our logo. Look. Higginsworth! So, you ever wonder where baby ghosts come from? If you're under the age of 12, don't listen to this. Ghost eggs. It's true. And these baby ghosts hide in the strangest places, like this bowl of water from BMW. This bowl of water looks normal, but it's not. There are thousands of baby ghost eggs ready to hatch. Look at this. And here they are. All right, so they're not baby ghosts. They're just these little hydrophilic spears. They're called jelly marbles. Where can you get them, Higginsworth? That's right, stevespanglerscience.com. Just one place. And when you put them in water, they absorb a tremendous amount of water. In fact, they start like this. Watch. These little tiny spheres are really, really, really small. You would never believe that they would grow into the size of these little marbles, but you don't need many. That's probably more than enough for this entire bowl that I'm playing with right now. So here's the science. If you use these clear spheres, then the index of refraction of this grown sphere that has the water inside is almost exactly that of water, meaning that the water doesn't bend once again when it goes through the jelly marble and then again when it goes through the water. This allows it to literally disappear. So as I pour it inside here, it looks like they vanish. Now you know why we call them ghost crystals. All right, so we pour all of the water out. Look at all the jelly marbles here. Now here's what you can tell people, that the hidden message, the secret message is hidden in the jelly marbles. And so you pour the jelly marbles into the container like this, and you say, here, can you read this secret message? Now all we need to reveal the secret message is just plain water. Watch. That's right, it's the Halloween edition. So you see how it works? Whatever message you want to reveal, you just put underneath the container here like this. So you're looking through the clear water here, and you reveal the message below. Well, now it's time for your own homework, because I want you to take the goldenrod paper, come up with your own secret message, or possibly use the solo cup and use the ultraviolet light for that message, or get some of the jelly marbles and make a secret message appear. Any of those, post it as a video response below. It's gonna be a great Halloween. All right, Higginsworth, it's cleaning up time. Right. So you think we can get a sponsorship?
No.
What do you mean? I mean, did you see all those that I said?
Well, yeah, but only about half of them were funny. I mean,
I thought all of them were funny.
Well, that makes I'm just trying to.
I didn't need to see you coming up with any ideas.
I was over here coming up with most of the ideas.
You didn't come up with any ideas. I'm saying, I mean, do you want a Sony TV? I do.
That's a good call, actually.
Right. I should have said Rolex. I have no watch. I don't even have a watch.
True, but
see,
think,
do you think well, Conan? BMW, Conan, bought, so. Conan has he has sponsors.
Yeah, but Conan's funny.
It's mean.
Yeah, sorry.
What if we had one episode where we just go, Walmart, 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 Walmart? Do you think we'd get their attention?
I mean, true, but I don't think Walmart would even want to watch that episode.
I would. I mean, I'd watch that a lot. How about glue brought to you by Home Depot? What about that?
Why not Elmer's?
I don't know. We're not going to get sponsorship, are we?
No. But I'll see what I can do. I know some people.
You should make some calls.
I'll get on that, Steve. I'm not gonna get sponsored.